Like, what if tomorrow all the power went out and the internet was gone and we were all forced to act locally? I feel like that would make us a lot more compassionate, because I think when you see people in their everyday environment, you realize how similar we are. These songs just all fell out together, and they fell out with the title too. Like, I knew I wanted to call them Uniform Distortion. There's a literal meaning where I wanted every sound on the album to be uniformly distorted. I wanted everything kind of across the board, whether it was a vocal or a drum or a guitar, to be uniformly blown up. Now, I felt like that tied into this theme of uniform distortion, how I feel like our news is distorted, our society is distorted, there's this blanket distortion over everything. But there's a real crisis right now of trying to figure out, how do we cut through this distortion? How do we get back to the truth? So I found Duane's image, the Illuminated Man, in the last Whole Earth catalog, which was basically like the internet before the internet. It was this amazing catalog where you could find out stuff about anything you were curious about. That came out in like 1971, and I bought it for $5 at the swap meet and was just looking through it, and I saw Duane's photo the way I saw it in the catalog. It's just, you see the torso of a person, you really can't even tell if it's a man or a woman, and their head is just exploding with light, and it just immediately jumped out to me of like what I thought this record sounded like and what I wanted people's heads to feel like when they heard the record, like your fucking head's exploding, you know, with the distortion. Just right when I saw it, I was like, that's the cover, if I can get it. I haven't talked to him at all, I've never met him, and I never heard from him. It was just like, we sent him our scan, and they're like, Duane only allows people to use his original image. Here's his original image. They emailed that back. I was like, whoa, that's so cool, but that's not at all what I'm looking for, because it doesn't look like this thing I love so much. So then I wrote him back my letter. I wrote him back this heartfelt letter and just got a response, okay, you can use the image. That was it. There was no interaction at all.
I am the original Duane Michals. I've worked with everybody, recently Tilda Swinton, Dustin Hoffman, Johnny Cash.
Well, I try to photograph dreams. I try to photograph anxiety. I try to photograph lust. Photographers feel comfortable photographing what they can see, but they never try to photograph what you can't see.
Yeah, I just believe in magic. I don't know why I went to the antique mall that day and found this catalog. And this is a tiny example of like my heart saying, pick up that book, that looks cool. And I try to listen to that. I almost see the image as a gateway that would take the person into hearing the music that I created, that then hopefully might encourage somebody to vote or might encourage some positive real world response from the art and the music. Okay.
Now, that photograph has been seen by many, many people, yeah. But there are those people who have a visceral response, those people who suddenly, you know, they understand that. And so you can show it to lots and lots of people, but you have to be ready to see it. I think of the mind as being luminous. Yeah. And you put shit in your head, you're going to have a shitty life, and you won't even notice. And so with this man, I wanted to do a picture where you could see the mind working. Right. He has stopped being, you know, Duane Drag, and he became his pure energy.
Right.
That's the pure energy.
If you're smart, you're always learning, you're absorbing, you know, the question is, what are you absorbing?
I was in a cab and I had this argument with a cab driver one day. And I said, well, where'd you get that idea? He said, well, I read it. I said, yeah, but where? I don't remember, but I read it. Was it in the Post
right.
or was it editorial right. New York Times? Check out the source. There's so much blowout of
distortion.
Total distortion.
Do you feel like each of us, not as an artist, just as a person, have an obligation to try and help our fellow man?
An artist has to deal with truth. And truth is a recognition of something that you feel and you see it. Like if you read a poem and there's a line and you, oh my God, I know, you know.
Yeah.
That's when, it only works when there's a connection, where there's, and the more intimate the connection, the more powerful it is. Somebody can write a simple sentence that breaks through the bullshit and gets right to the heart of the matter, and you think, well, yeah, you know, there's this. And because we're all desperate for touching is so important, and artists in whatever way touch.
Thank you for letting me use the image.
Thank
it really
Jesus.
Means a lot.
Oh, please.
Really, no, I'm serious. Because you could have said no, you know?